Hundreds of children rely on its services, but are efforts to revamp the state's foster care program working?
We remain strongly committed to reforming the child welfare and juvenile services system.
But some question whether the state is providing enough resources and oversight to change the system. Good evening, I'm Brandi Peterson.
I'm Rob McCartney. State leaders and foster care providers defend Nebraska's attempt to privatize its child welfare system.
It comes after three of the state's lead contractors leave the system and one, Visinet, declares bankruptcy.
In the big story at 6, are these just growing pains or is the state moving too fast? KETV NewsWatch 7's Andrew Ozaki takes a closer look.
Nebraska is only a few months into its plan to privatize the way it takes care of kids at risk or in trouble. But already, Visinet is gone, another company withdrew before entering a contract, and Cedars and Lincoln pulled out, saying it couldn't afford to lose $550,000 if it continues to work with the state. Child advocacy groups say it's a red flag.
When three of six providers have said, I don't have enough money to do an effective job, then I want the state to listen to that.
But Health and Human Service officials said Thursday they are committed to using the private sector to reduce the number of kids who remain out of homes, saying it could be a 2 to 5 year process.
We will be talking to the lead contractors to say, do we need to be doing something in terms of changing how we provide services?
But they don't know if extra funding is an option.
There's not a lot of dollars.
In the meantime, the state is trying to track down all the former Visinet foster families and pay them for any services they are still owed.
We absolutely do not want to lose any foster parents, and we don't want to disrupt any kids from placement.
Last week, an HHS placed five Visinet kids in the staff secure section of Lincoln's detention center because there was no other place to put them. And there are more reported disruptions.
A number of children have missed therapy services or other services, have missed visitation with their parents.
But other private agencies defend reform, saying they remain committed to make it work.
And our business model is such that we're prepared for the long haul.
Still others are calling for more oversight on the process and if kids are really getting served any better.
Administration has said it's very new, just give it time. My concern is what's happening to children day to day during that time period.
Andrew Ozaki, KETV, NewsWatch 7.
A judge denied Visinet's bankruptcy filing in court. HHS says that allows them to work directly with providers to make sure payments continue. The state is urging foster parents who were with Visinet to contact their case managers so they can determine what emergency care is needed.